Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel Himanshu Nagarkar. Today's video is actually something which is a close memory, very, very, very special to my heart, very close to my heart. It was way back in the year 2011 when I had just started my career as a trainer. So it was, I think, 2 years into training, and I was invited by the Uttarakhand Nehru Institute of Mountaineering, wherein they had selected around 25 cadets all over India. And out of those 25 cadets, 5 cadets were to be selected for the Siachen Glacier. So a day before, all the cadets come from all parts of India. There are some from Karnataka, some from Maharashtra, from Punjab, from Bihar, from Madhya Pradesh, Uttarakhand, from all over the places, 25 cadets were selected. So today they reach at the Uttarakhand, that whatever base it is, I can't take the name, but the Uttarakhand base which they had come, and from tomorrow their training was supposed to begin. Now before I tell you, let me just tell you the story, let me tell you a little geographical condition about Uttarakhand. See, the Uttarakhand winter and the winters in Kashmir, there's a lot of difference. What happens in Uttarakhand winter is the winds blow so high that the cold really pricks onto you. You know, it becomes really difficult to totally gauge the Uttarakhand winter. As opposed to the winters in Kashmir, the Kashmiri winters you can easily take care of it. Yeah. So even though the Uttarakhand temperature is 4, because of the heavy winds, the temperature will drop down to maybe 1, minus 1 or minus 2. So coming back to the story, these 25 cadets land up there. And the next day drill is like this. 4 a.m. will be the first whistle. They all have to wake up. 4:02, they have to line up at the place where something will be kept. 4:03, a whistle will be blown. And let me tell you what happens next. So the next day comes up. 4 o'clock, the first whistle blows. I was also all ready because I wanted to see all the trainees, whom am I going to train for. So Major Thapa was the one who was the commander in chief out there, the CEO out there. So he blows the first whistle at 4 o'clock. 4:02, these cadets come, and 4:03, the third whistle blows. Now here the catch is that they have to get assembled there, removing all their clothes, just on their basic inners, yeah, and 25 cadets standing in front of them, 25 buckets, half filled with water, half filled with ice. And remember, it's the Uttarakhand cold. Yes, temperature must be around minus one or ranging around 0, -1. Yeah, but remember, they have come from all across India, where they have not even experienced temperature below 4 degrees Celsius. Yeah, so 25 cadets, 25 buckets. And at the third whistle, they have to take the buckets onto them, filled with half ice, half water. And after that, there will be a national anthem that will be played for 42 seconds. Now, you know, it's I can tell you all this with a smile on my face. Trust me, when I was witnessing the whole situation, there was no smile on my face. I was awestruck. There's a big awe, like, what exactly is happening? Those 42 seconds, all the cadets were freezing cold. They were like, their entire body was shivering like anything. Of course, after that they went, some of them fell sick and all of that. So that was all the things that happened after this. Now immediately after that, at the breakfast, I met the CEO, yes, Major Thapa out there. And I said, sir, I mean, I can understand the whole purpose behind this drill. You know, you want them to get used to the cold, the Uttarakhand cold, so that they are eventually ready for Siachen Glacier. But on the day one, they have not even gotten acclimatized, and you want them to take a ice bucket water on the day one of landing. I mean, you know, we have all done the ice bucket challenge and all those challenges on Facebook, Instagram. That's very easy. But remember, they have come there for the first time. Yeah. So I said, Major Thapa, you know, for them to beat the cold, such a harsh, severe thing on day one. Major Thapa started laughing. And what he said was actually the turning point of my life. You know, I still remember the words he said, and they got into me like a straight arrow goes when shot. He says, you know, Himanshu sir, you know, he used to address all the trainers as sir. Yeah, he said, Himanshu sir, it's not the cold that I want them to get used to. I was like, then what else would be the purpose of this? He said, I simply want to kill their mind. And I was like for those 10-15 seconds, brief seconds, there was a silence. I didn't say anything. Yeah. But when he said that, it's not the body with on whom, you know, it's not the body I want them to get acclimatized to the cold, but it is actually the mind that I want to kill. And then he continued saying, it's not the body that feels the cold weather, it's actually the mind that decides whether I want to feel cold, I want to feel hot. And then he continued saying, you know, there are so many sadhus who stay in the Himalayas who are totally naked and they are sitting on the ice and they are meditating for hours and days and hours and without food, without anything. So he says, how come their body does not feel cold and there are some bodies that feel cold? So it's not the body, he says it's the mind. And when I heard that, there was a lot of change inside me that came up. You know, ultimately, whatever we experience, it is actually the mind that experiences. Yeah. So, you know, little things that I used to crib about, you know, if there's a little less salt in the food, I used to really get paranoid. And I used to tell my mom, no, I don't want this food, make me some other food. You know, those little discomforts in life. You know, you're traveling somewhere and some person comes and asks for a seat and you get little paranoid. So these little discomforts are not really discomforts on the body. They are there only on the mind. Yeah. So I want to tell everybody through this video that, you know, it's always the mind that gets into a lot of problems. You know, it's not really the body, it's the mind that gets into a lot of problems. If we get the skill to silence our mind, you know, to make our mind go into a brief level of silence, you know, not really getting our mind too cloggered into it, it will help us a lot to get out of people, to get out of the situations and be more happy in life. Yeah, so thank you so much for watching this video. I'm signing off. Please do tell me in the comment section below how you like this video. I would really love if you can put some comments. Definitely write what all topics would you like me to make videos on. Signing off, Himanshu. Bye-bye.